So here is the full list of jump instructions that we'll use in x86-64. So we have the unconditional jump up here. We have an indirect jump, which we're not going to talk about too much in this course. And then we have a bunch of the conditional jumps. Some of these have what are called synonyms. So for instance, the jump equal is the same as jump zero. It really just tests the zero flag and jumps if that zero flag is set. So these are the jump names. These are their synonym if they have one. And then this is the combination of flags that that particular jump takes. You don't need to memorize this table. I would strongly advise not attempting to memorize this table. The table will be useful later on this semester because you will need to implement some of these in one of the programming projects. So it's useful to keep a reference to this table. But for now, it's important to just kind of be aware of what kind of instructions there are. One other thing to note here is that this group of instructions here, so the greater and less than instructions, are very similar to the above or below instructions, which is this group down here. But because of the flags that are checked, essentially this group is dealing with signed comparisons, and this group is dealing with unsigned comparisons. So again, information is bits plus context. You're the one who knows whether you're working with signed or unsigned data, so you're the one who needs to make sure that you're using the appropriate comparison or the appropriate jump instruction. It's the same compare instruction, right? It sets all the flags appropriately regardless of whether it's signed or unsigned data. And so it's up to you to do the correct conditional jump. I'll take a moment here just to mention conditional moves. We're not going to use these very much right now, but they'll come back later this semester, and so I wanted to go ahead and mention them. So a conditional move is like a conditional jump, except that it just moves data instead of jumping, but it only does that move if certain flags are set. So it's kind of an optional move that happens only if a certain condition is met. So for instance, here we have a comparison. So we compare RBX with RAX. If RBX is greater than RAX, then we'll jump down to this label. Otherwise, we'll execute this instruction, which moves RAX into RCX. And then down here, we move RBX into RCX. So essentially what this is doing is it's grabbing the maximum of RBX and RAX, because if RBX is greater than RAX, then we'll jump down to here where we'll store RBX and RCX. And then if RBX is actually less than or equal to RAX, then we'll end up executing this one. So this could be equivalently expressed using a conditional move. So we could go ahead and move RAX into RCX, and then we could compare RBX to RAX. And if RBX is greater than RAX, then we can just move RBX into RCX instead of RAX. If RBX is less than or equal to, then it'll just RCX will stay the old value from RAX. And you may wonder why we need these. There's kind of two reasons. The first is that it's shorter, right, in order to do the same amount of work. But there's actually a significant performance benefit to doing a conditional move versus the conditional jumps. And that's because of something called branch prediction, which we haven't talked about yet, but it will come up again later this semester, and so I wanted to go ahead and introduce it. If you haven't seen them yet, there's also this thing called a ternary expression in C that allows you to do sort of a similar thing in C. And I mention that because this will be useful in some of the programming projects. So if you've never seen this construct before, it's worth going and looking to see how this works. Basically, it tests a condition. If it's true, you get this value. If it's false, you get this value.